Very good morning. Today we'll discuss multimedia concept in application layer. Multimedia generally requires high bandwidth. Before that, what is a digital audio you want to know? The audio generally called as a sound wave in one dimensional pressure wave, you can call this. The frequency range of human ear runs from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz here. Audio waves can be converted into digital form by ADC. So ADC stands for analog digital converter. An ADC takes an electrical voltage as an input and generates binary number as an output here. So generally in internet audio and video, we have three methods. One is streaming stored audio or video, streaming live audio or video, interactive audio or video here. So generally media player has four jobs to do: manage user interface, handle transmission errors, decompress the music, eliminate the jitter here. So coming to the streaming stored audio videos, refers to on demand request for the compressed audio or video files here. Coming to the streaming live audio video, refers to broadcasting of radio and TV programs through the internet. Coming to the interactive audio video, refers to use of the internet for interactive audio or video applications here. So generally the compression is needed to send a video over the internet here. So coming to the streaming stored audio video, we have four approaches here. We'll discuss four approaches. So downloading these three files from web server can be a different from downloading other types of files. So we have four approaches. First, using the web server, compressed audio or video file can be downloaded as a text file here. So client browser, generally client browser can use services of HTTP. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, and send the GET message to download a file. Now web server can send compressed file to the browser here. Browser can then use help of application normally called a media player to play a file. It does not need any streaming after downloading here. So coming to the next approach, using a web server with a meta file. So generally media player is directly connected to the web server here for downloading audio or video file. So generally what the web server stores two files here. One is actual audio file or video file. One is the meta file. Meta file stands for information about the audio file or video file. So the process is like this. First, HTTP client access web server by using the GET message. Information about the meta file comes in the response from the web server. Meta file is passed to the media player. Now the media player uses the URL of audio or video file in a meta file to access the audio or video file. Then web server responds. Coming to the third approach, using the media server. Problem with the second approach is browser and media player both uses the services of HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So generally HTTP is designed to run over the TCP only. So this is appropriate for retrieving meta file but not retrieving the audio or video file here. So HTTP, which access web server and web server itself, are designed for TCP. We need another server, media server. So what are you doing here? So first of all, HTTP client access web server using the GET message. Information about the meta file comes in the response to the browser. Now metap file is passed to the media player. Media player uses the URL in metap file to access the media server to downloading the file. Downloading can take place by any protocol that uses the UDP here. So for downloading purpose, we are using the UDP protocol. For sending a request, we are using the HTTP request here. So now in the response, media server responds here to the media player. Coming to the fourth approach. So using media server and RTSP. RTSP stands for real-time streaming protocol. So RTSP is a control protocol designed to add more functionalities to streaming process here. Control playing of audio video files is out of bound control protocol, generally RTSP. So coming to the process, HTTP client access web server using the GET message, and information about the meta file comes in the response. Meta file again passed to the media player. Media player sends setup message to create the connection with the media server here. Now media server responds, and media player sends play message to start the playing. Now audio file or video file is downloaded by using another protocol that runs over the UDP here. So connection is broken by using teardown message, and media server response here. So generally we are using two protocols again. One is RTSP, UDP, as well as the HTTP protocol. Three protocols. So coming to the streaming live audio video. Streaming live audio video is similar to the broadcasting of your audio or video by radio, and TV stations. Instead of broadcasting to the air, the station broadcasts to the internet. So there are several similarities between streaming stored audio video and streaming live audio video. They are both sensitive to delay. Neither they can accept retransmission. However, there is a difference. In the first application, the communication is unicast on and on demand. In the second, the communication is multicast and live. Coming to real-time interactive audio video. In real-time interactive audio video, people communicate with one another in real time. The internet phone or voice or IP is an example of this type of application. Video conferencing is another example that allows people to communicate visually or orally. So jitter is introduced in real time data by delay between the packets. So to prevent jitter, we can timestamp the packets and separate the arrival time from the playback time. A playback buffer is required for real-time traffic here. A sequence number on each packet is required for real-time traffic here. Real-time traffic needs the support of multicasting, and translation means changing the encoding of a payload to lower quality to match the bandwidth of receiving network here. Mixing means combining several streams of traffic into one stream. TCP, with all its sophistication, it is not suitable for interactive multimedia traffic because we cannot allow retransmission of packets here. UDP is more suitable than TCP for interactive traffic here. However, we need the services of RTP, real-time protocol, another transport layer protocol, to make up for the deficiencies of the UDP here. So coming to the voice over IP, one real-time interactive audio video application is voice over IP or internet telephony here. Idea to use internet as a telephone network with some additional capabilities. This application allows to communicate our communication between the two parties over the packet switching network here. So generally we are using two protocols are designed to handle this type of communication. One is SIP, next one is the H.323. SIP is a session initiation protocol and designed by the IETF, Internet Engineering Task Force. IETF stands for Internet Engineering Task Force. It is application protocol that establishes, manages, and terminates a multimedia session here. It can be used to create two parties, multi-parties, or multicast sessions here. SIP designed to be independent of underlying transport layer. It can run on UDP, TCP, or SCTP. So SIP messages generally is a text-based protocol. SIP is a text-based protocol. We have so many messages here. One is invite, acknowledge, buy, options, cancel, register here. Each message has a header and body here. Caller initiates a session with invite message. After callee answers, the caller sends acknowledgement message to the confirmation. The buy message terminates the session. Options message queries a machine about its capabilities. Cancels already started initialization process. Register message makes connection when caller is not available. Coming to the H.323 architecture, H.323 is a standard designed by the ITU, International Telecommunication Union, to allow telephones and public telephone network to talk to computers called terminals in H.23. Okay, now these are terminals, these are different terminals connected to the internet. A gateway connects to internet to telephone network. We need a from gateway to connect to internet here. Gateway is a file layer device that can translate message from one protocol stack to the another protocol. It transforms telephone network messages to an internet message. Gatekeeper server on local area network plays role of register server here. Protocols, H.323 uses number of protocols to establish and maintain voice communication. H.323 uses the G.271 and G.723.1 for compression here. Thank you.